Hello, Leo. How are you guys doing? Welcome into the reading. In this reading, we're going to be looking at any love blocks that you might be having and how to see what the love block is and then how to solve it. So let's go. Let's clear the space of any previous readings and energies and send positive vibes through to you guys out there. So for some reason, I feel like smudging my cards for you guys as well. Leo, let's do that. Let's go. So I'm doing this very differently. I'm going to show you the guys the cards, okay? And we're going to allow spirit to show us what is your block and what is your solution by seeing what comes up with the reading as well. We're going to see where is the Two of Cups, the Ace of Cups, or the Lover's card, guys. So scream out. There we go. Ace of Cups energy. Five of Swords. Wow. This is your love story right over there. Your love block. We're looking at it. Five of Swords energy, win or lose. Coming up in the love block section, the Ace of Cups shows me new person, and the Judgment card rocks up here. Very, very, very strong message coming through. It talks about what has been, the problems that you've carried in the past. Your love block, I feel like, honestly, I'm reading for somebody who has been through quite a lot, hey? With regards to love, I feel like you've been through more than most people have been through. You've had some experiences that have not been very good, and you've experienced a lot. You, for some of you guys, I almost feel like you carry like a residual energy of being angry with regards to love because of what has happened. It's almost like, it's, you know, sometimes people, when they've been hurt by more than one person, they start to look at the general population, you know what I mean, and be like, hey, but men, or hey, women, you know, like I do that sometimes. I'm like, when I get mad with things, I'm like, hey, but men, sometimes, trust me, you know. But the thing is, I feel like you're carrying that, and that is what is causing a problem there. The love block is what has occurred and how it has changed your perception of love. Okay, you got a Five of Swords there, which is literally win or lose. It's like, boom, there's no middle ground here. The Ace of Cups coming in, which is love abounds. Spirit guide is literally going, by the way, you have got a new person that's coming in. You haven't yet met this person, but there is an energy of something new. You got a Judgment card as well, which is unbelievably good. Okay, these cards just go. I'm going to take whatever's on the bottom. Let's place them. Got a Two of Pentacles. You got to let it go, guys. You gotta let it go. You gotta let it go. Let's see what else I'm taking from the bottom. There we go. You gotta let it go. Yo, they're saying, we know. We know. And we're gonna put this one here. We know. Then, like Spirit Guide says, we know. You may have come from a marriage that did not work out. Or you were living with somebody. If it wasn't that like that, it was a very strong connection. It was going to a place of Ten of Pentacles. And you put so much effort into this. So much of yourself. That's why you could be angry. It's almost like you've given your heart, your soul, your mind, your body, everything, your energy, your dreams, your thoughts to this connection, and somebody just took that totally for granted and did whatever they did. You had to release this connection. They are also asking you to release the pain now as well. Even though I don't feel like you're in this connection anymore, I kind of like feel like you're still holding the pain of the connection with you. So let's see. With the Judgment card coming up here, it is your solution. Judgment card talks about an ending of a cycle. And when the cycle ends, sometimes we hold on to cycles. We're out of it, but our energy is still in it, if you know what I mean. It's like our body left, but our energy is still there. And this is what they're talking about here. They're talking about you releasing what does no longer serve you, because this is a card of karma. It tells me you've had some experiences that are related to karma that you actually had to go through. To heal this, you have to release it. You have to let it go. You have to send peace to it, not to the person. I don't feel like people deserve peace and all those kinds of things. It's for you. It's not for anyone else. You're doing this for you because you need to be okay. You know what I mean? So with this energy coming in here, you release this, you bring it in something unbelievably positive in your future. Let's see. Let's ask Spirit Guide to show us more into the solution. Wow, I love this reading. I like doing this. This is very nice energy. Let's see. It's these two. Let's see what these two cards say. Without a doubt, you got a person coming in here. You have a person. You got to release the pain. This could have been a marriage, hey? Because you've got the Empress coming up with the Ten of Pentacles. You may even have a child with this person that really hurt you like this. You got to release this. You got to release this. You got to let it go. You got to let go of the fear that you will never have this because you are going to have it. The Empress is here. So it shows me that in the future, you got a Fool card. You got the Ace of Cups. There is a love coming for you. I almost feel like you're going, in this whole entire planet, there is no one for me. Oh, there is a person for you. Oh, there is a person for you. It's just that you don't see it yet. The Empress is still in the reverse position. All you're seeing still is what was. The pain that you got from that Five of Swords. Those swords got stuck into your back, and that's what you're still currently seeing. It is causing you not to see what the potential of is, what is still coming for you. With this Blossom card, you've got to release it. You've got to let go of the pain. You've got to take every sword out of you, and you've got to let it go. You've got to let it go like it doesn't exist. You're never going to talk about it again. You're never going to think about it again. Every time you think about something negative, think about flowers. I'm just saying, oh wow, if it was only that easy, hey? Gee whiz. You know, it's like you have to go through the process of releasing so that you can have a new beginning. There's no other way. Let's see what Spirit Guide has got to say for you. No, it's to you. Let's have a look. This is coming. Oh my goodness. They're letting you know. Please, please, please. Guys, they're letting you know. You got an Eight of Wands. It's coming very quickly. This person is not very far. You know when it gets the worst? You know when we get to that point where we 100% go, it never going to happen. That's when it's about to happen. You know when things get really bad? That's when it's about to change. And that's when you cannot give up. And that's when you need to do the work the most. When it's really bad, when you're really in a low place and you're feeling really sad with regards to anything, that's when you really need to start working on yourself on an energetic level like this, to release pain, to change energy, to shift what is inside of you. And to do so, you can do so many different things, you know, just by putting yourself into a good, happy place, doing things that you like doing, putting your mind out of the place of pain and keeping yourself busy and even getting into enthusiastic about doing something new as well makes a really big change. Like redecorating your home, doing all those things make huge changes. You know, what I recently did in 2021 is like empty out everything out my house. I did it for like 2 months. I took down everything. I took down every painting, every ornament, everything that wasn't necessary. And I just lived in an empty space for a while. That's what you need to do. To clear energy, because that success and this growth is coming very quickly. Success and growth with regards to love, you've got a new person coming in. Will do anything you can to release the old energy. Even smudge out your house, get some sage and just go crazy. You know what I mean? Because you got a person coming in. There we go. I'm sending you so much love and light, Leo. I wish you the best moving forward. If you do resonate with the reading, please hit that thumbs up button for me. Even subscribe because the readings do come out on a daily basis. Sending love and light to all of you. Bye.